Good afternoon, dear students. I welcome you all for this fifth lecture of our course, that is Fundamental of Systematics. In last lecture, we studied about the biological classification system, basically the four kingdom classification system by Copeland and five kingdom classification system by R.H. Whittaker. We also looked at the merits and demerits of those two systems, and we studied the details of all the kingdoms which are mentioned. Now, in this last part of this biological classification lecture, we will study the remaining systems which come after this. So, in last lecture, we saw how in the five kingdom classification system, Whittaker introduced the fifth kingdom, that is kingdom fungi, by which now fungi got a separate place as a kingdom. Now the next system of classification was six kingdom classification system. It was proposed by Karl Woods in the year 1980. So around that period there was emphasis on phylogenetic relationship and redefining the kingdoms to be monophyletic. So Karl Woods was a professor in the Department of Microbiology, University of Illinois. He came up with this six kingdom classification system in 1990. So Animalia, Plantae and Fungi were generally reduced to core group and closely related forms, and other forms thrown into the kingdom Protista. So all this work was based on the RNA studies. So earlier there was lack of distinction between Archaebacteria and Bacteria. So kingdom Monera, which was proposed by R.H. Whittaker, is now replaced by two kingdoms by Karl Woods, and these two newly formed kingdoms are Bacteria and Archae. All this classification into two kingdom, that is it Bacteria Archae, was done by based on the ribosomal RNA structure studies. Okay, later on this six kingdom classification system was also led to the basis for what is known as three domain system. So in next slides we will see that this three domain system, where Bacteria, Archae and Eukaryota are the three domains were defined. Okay, so with this diagram we'll see the six kingdom classification. So as you remember, in the Whittaker system of five kingdom, there was Monera kingdom, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Now this Monera kingdom of Whittaker is being divided into two sub kingdoms, or rather two separate kingdoms, that is kingdom Archaebacteria and kingdom Eubacteria. So this was the addition of the six kingdom classification system by Woods. So now let's see the characters of Archae. So Archaea, or basically the Archaebacteria, are nothing but the ancient bacteria. They are the prokaryotic organisms, and all this classification, as I told, is based on their ribosomal RNA studies. So 16S rRNA studies were done, and based on this they were classified into Archaea or into the Eubacteria. So this kingdom includes early prokaryotes. So as we say, Archaea means an ancient prokaryotes. So all the ancient prokaryotes were included in the kingdom Archaea. So these were basically the extremophiles. So these could be methanogens, which can live in high concentration of methane, halophiles, which can live in high concentration of NaCl, and thermoacidophiles, which can live at different higher conditions of or lower conditions of temperature, as well as acidic conditions. Bacteria, the second kingdom which was established by this system, has some characteristics. So this consists of the typical prokaryotes that lack cell membrane covered cell organelles. So all the recent organisms or unicellular prokaryotes, they are included in the Eubacteria kingdom. They do not have microchambers for separating various metabolic activities. So as we know, in eukaryotes, in prokaryotes, there is no such separation of cell, or there is no demarcation of the or presence of any organelles. So all the metabolic activities takes place within that single cell as a unit. So this kingdom was called as Eubacteria. Now let's quickly see what are the merits of this six kingdom classification system. So there are two merits. Firstly, the grouping of all the unicellular eukaryotes under the kingdom Protista has solved many problems. So particularly which were related to the position of organisms like Euglena. So we have seen that in previous R.H. Whittaker systems of five kingdom classification, Euglena did not have any place in any of the kingdom. So this problem was considered in this system. Then kingdom Metaphyta and Metazoa are now become more homogeneous in nature. Okay, so kingdom that means Plantae and Animalia. So this was the major advantage, or rather the merit of six kingdom classification system, that they become more homogeneous in terms of the phylogeny of these groups with other groups. So these two are the basic merits of six kingdom classification system. But there were certain demerits of this system of six kingdom, that is still slime mold, which differed totally from other members of Protista in their organization. So they could not get still a proper position. So they were placed into the kingdom Protista, but they do not share the exact properties like the protists. Next, viruses, like we have seen in five kingdom classification system, they have not any place. Similarly, in this system also, viruses, viroids or prions did not get any position. So this was the second major drawback of this system. Now this six kingdom classification system was further modified into what is called as a three domain system. So all these six kingdoms were classified into three major domains. What are these three domains? First domain is bacteria, which includes all the Eubacteria or true bacteria. Second domain is archaea, which include all ancient bacteria, and the third domain is eukaryota. So this third domain is the largest domain, which includes all the animals, that is kingdom Animalia, kingdom Plantae, all the protists and all the fungi. So all these are included in the third domain, that is domain eukaryota. Now we move on to the next dimension or next system of classification that was added, that is the eight kingdom classification system. So this system is also known by the name Cavalier-Smith concept. So because it was proposed by these two scientists, that is Cavalier and Smith, in 1987. So now this concept is also based on rRNA sequencing as well as the ultrastructure characteristic study. So these were the two basic criteria that were considered for the classification into eight kingdoms. Now these eight kingdoms are divided into two empires. What are these two empires? So this is also called as a two empire system. So the first empire is known as Empire Bacteria, which further consists of two kingdoms, that is Eubacteria and Archaebacteria. And second empire is called as Eukaryota, which contains remaining six kingdoms of life, that is Archaeozoa, Protozoa, Chromista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. In next slide it will be more clear. Archaeozoa and Chromista. So if you see, compare this system with the previous system, these are the newly introduced kingdoms in the eukaryotes. Okay, so here you will get clear picturization. So this eight kingdom system, which was proposed by Cavalier and Smith, the year is 1998. It is based on ultrastructure characters, RNA sequences, and other molecular data. And here you can see there are two empires. So the first empire is Empire Bacteria. It includes all the prokaryotes. May it be ancient bacteria or the true bacteria. Those two kingdoms are clubbed together into the Empire Bacteria. And second empire, that is Empire Eukaryota, consists of remaining six kingdoms. Consists of remaining six kingdoms, that is Archaeozoa, Protozoa, Plantae, Chromista, Fungi, and Animalia. So the new kingdoms which are included are the Archaeozoa and Chromista. So this eight kingdom classification system, kingdom Archaeozoa, which is newly introduced now, it consists of primitive eukaryotes, which are unicellular microorganisms. So previously, if you see, all the eukaryotic unicellular organisms were included in the protista. So there was this anomaly that some organism, though they do not share proper characteristics of protist, they were included in the protista. So to remove them from protista, another kingdom, that is Archaeozoa, was established. So for example, Giardia, which possesses 70S type of ribosomes, but it lacked the cell organelles. So major all the cell organelles are absent, like Golgi, mitochondria, chloroplast, peroxisomes. So though it shows 70S type of ribosomes, but it is lacking the cell organelles, so it is a eukaryotic unicellular microorganism. So it got a place into this new kingdom, that is Archaeozoa. Similarly, the second new kingdom established in eight kingdom system was known as kingdom Chromista. So it includes diatoms, brown algae, cryptomonads, and oomycetes. So these were the groups which were left out in the previous system. They did not have any place. Now they got a new kingdom for themselves, which is known as kingdom Chromista. So here the four kingdoms, that is Plantae, Fungi, Animalia, and Protista, they were retained as it is, like in the previous system of classification. But here their boundaries are redefined. So you can easily distinguish between each kingdom and the organisms which are included in that particular kingdom. So they got a very well-defined boundaries for that particular kingdom. This is all about the eight kingdom classification system. The last system of classification is known as seven kingdom system or the two empire system. So the same scientist, that is Cavalier and Smith and their collaborator, they have revised their previous system of eight kingdoms into the newer system, that is a seven kingdom system. So in this scheme, they reintroduced the division of prokaryotes into two kingdoms, that is bacteria and archaebacteria. So this system is based on the what is called as a catalog of life, that is taxonomic outline of bacteria and archae. So in this chart, you will get a clear overview of this seven kingdom system. So two empires, that is Empire Prokaryota and Empire Eukaryota, were retained. Prokaryotes have been divided into bacteria and archae, and Empire Eukaryota, which was comprising of six kingdom in the previous eight kingdom system, they are now limited to the five kingdoms. So if you could see here, Archaeozoa is missing, and here we have kingdom Protozoa, Chromista, Plantae, Fungi, and Animalia. So this is now in the okay. Now in this chart, we will compare all these systems of classification proposed over a period of time. So we have studied the first system of classification, which was proposed by Carlos Linnaeus in the year 1735, which is known as two kingdom classification system, that is Kingdom Plantae and Kingdom Animalia. The second system of classification is known as three kingdom classification system, which was proposed by Ernst Haeckel in the year 1866. So here the third kingdom in the form of protista was added. Later on, there was another system proposed. Okay, so there, along with this kingdom system, there were empire system. So in between, you can see a system of empire proposed by Chatham in the year 1925, where he divided all the organisms into two simple empires, that is empire prokaryota and empire eukaryota. But here there is no distinction. So in 1938, Copeland came with a four kingdom classification system, because still some of the organism were not, because or rather newer organisms were discovered over a period of time, and these new organism had some characteristics which could not fit in any of the kingdom which were earlier present. So there was a need of newer kingdom. So Copeland came up with a four kingdom classification system, which comprises of Monera, Protista, Plantae and Animalia. Okay, again the problem is still there, that where to fit fungi, because earlier they were classified into the Plantae, but it was not proper classification. So in the year 1969, R.H. Whittaker came up with a system of five kingdom classification system, where he created a new kingdom, that is kingdom fungi, to include all the micro fungi as well as macro fungi. Okay, later on this system was replaced by a six kingdom classification system by Carl Woods, where he divided the kingdom Monera simply into two kingdoms, that is kingdom Eubacteria and kingdom Archaebacteria. This is like the baseline for the three domain system, which was proposed by Carl Woods himself only in 1990, where he divided the six kingdom into three domains, that is domain Bacteria, domain Archaea and domain Eukaryota. Further, we looked at the eight kingdom system, which was proposed by Cavalier and Smith, where they have introduced two new kingdoms, that is Archaeozoa and kingdom Chromista. So here in Archaeozoa, you are including all the eukaryotic unicellular organisms, and in Chromista, the other organisms which were not properly fitting into the protozoans. And then we have seen the six kingdom classification system, where Bacteria, Protozoa, Chromista, Plantae, Fungi and Animalia were the kingdoms. Also we have looked at the final system, that is seven kingdom classification system, where we saw that this Archaeozoa being removed from this system of classification, and they got a place in either protozoans or chromists. So this is all for today's lecture. So we summarize. Today we saw the remaining systems of classification, that is six kingdom classification system, eight kingdom classification system. Also we studied what is mean by three domain classification system, two empire classification system, which is also called as a eight kingdom classification system, and finally the most recent version, which is known as a seven kingdom classification system. So with this we conclude today's lecture. Just hearing.